Hello friends, welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to create this beautiful looking glitter extensions. So before we start, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified about all my new videos. So let's begin. To do the extensions, I'll be using Model 1's Polygel extension kit. So you must have seen this kit in my previous video, so I'm using the same kit here. In this one, I have all the basic colors such as white, soft pink, dark pink, nude, etc. And as you can see, I also have base coat, top coat, slip solution and a little bit of nail decoration items and the dual forms and then a filer and a brush. This kit comes with all the things that you need to do the polygel extension, and also we have this small catalog, and I'll be using this soft pink, this shade as a cover pink, you can say cover, to cover the gel. I'll be using that one, and from the second kit I'll be using the glitter polygel. So in this kit we have all the glitter polygels, and obviously rest of the things are the same: file, base coat, top coat, slip solution and the decoration and the dual forms. So this is how these kits are. So if you're a beginner and you just wanted to start with polygel extension, this is the best thing you can buy, and you can also use my code AMMU10 to get a 10% off from their website. I'll put all the links in the description box, and you can check it out in case if you wanted to buy. So let's begin with our extensions. For the extensions, I will be using this brush. This one has a spatula on one side and the other side is the brush. So this brush comes along with the polygel kit. And the second item is the slip solution. And you also need a dipping dish to pour the slip solution. Unlike acrylic liquid, you don't need so much slip solution. You'll only need a little bit just to dip the brush and, you know, just to manipulate the gel. So you don't need so much. Next, I'll be using nail forms to sculpt the nails. We have the dual forms, but I have never tried the dual forms, so I thought I'll stick with forms, and I'll be making a separate video with the dual forms very soon. But for now, I'm using nail forms. So what I'm doing is I'm just strengthening the forms using that little piece that we have here, and after that I'm going to align the forms with my nails. So before we actually go to this step, we need to prep our natural nails. So I already had extensions on, so I do not have to do much prep work. But in case if you're not familiar with the preparation work, then you can check out my first acrylic extension video on my channel. I'll put the link somewhere on the screen here. There I have already explained what are the things we need to check before we start with the extension, basically the prep work. So I have now set up the forms. The form is well aligned and I can start with my extension. Next step, I'm going to apply a very thin layer of base coat. Again, this step I was supposed to do before I put on the foam, but just like last time, I forgot to apply the base coat before the foam application. But anyways, I'm just applying a very thin layer of base coat, and then I cure it under the UV lamp for 30 seconds. After that, I'm going to start with the poly gel. First, I'm using the glitter gel. I'll be building the free edge first, and then I'll move on to the cuticle area. So you can directly apply the poly gel onto the tip or the nails, or you can use the spatula to pick up the gel and then you can place it on your nails. Once you place the bead, use your brush to manipulate the gel and you can create the length and shape of your extension. Unfortunately, I forgot to hit the recording button here again, just like my last video. I don't know what I was thinking. But anyways, I already formed the length and shape of my nails, and now I'm quickly going to cure it under the UV lamp for 30 seconds. Now the extension that I built, that is really thin and it's not really opaque. I need more glitter, so I'm going for one more bead, a little thicker bead, and then I'm going to just spread it across the extension that I have already built. So here the only difference is, as you can see on the screen, I am just trying to feather out the glitter. So this way we can ensure that when we do the covering or encapsulation with the clear pink, it will not be like a clear line from where the glitter is starting. So it will give a faded look. So that's what I'm doing So I'm just spreading the, or in fact I'm fading the glitter, and then I'm building the rest of the shape. So I'm just ensuring that the tip is thick enough, and then I will be using the cover pink to build the cuticle and apex area. So the one thing that I'm doing a little different here is that since I'm not a expert with poly gel yet, I create small areas and then I cure it under the UV lamp, and then I come back and I apply more product, and then I build the entire nail. So that is a technique, if you're a beginner you can follow. Now second, I'm going with my clear pink, so I'll be building my apex now. As you can see, I placed my second bead, or the clear pink bead, right in the middle of my nails, and then I am ensuring that I am reaching both the side walls of my nails, and then I am just feathering the gel towards the tip of my nails. So I'll be using this same gel as my cover gel, because I don't have a clear poly gel, so I'll be using the same gel as to encapsulate my glitter actually, and my cuticle area also I'm going to use the same gel. So this way you can see the glitter, and the gel is semi-transparent, and you can also do the encapsulation, so it won't be like very blinky nails, but it will be a subtle nail. So that's what I wanted to create. So I am just ensuring that the gel is equally spread across the nail, and then I'll be building my cuticle area. For the cuticle area, I picked up another bead and I placed it near the cuticle area. Then I'll be using my brush to push down the product. When you do this, please ensure that you are not pushing down the product underneath the skin. You have to leave a small hairline gap between the product and your cuticle area. After that, I'm dragging the product towards the tip of my nails. But if you notice, when I'm doing this, I'm not really pushing the center side of the nail, because that's where the apex is going to be. And since it's a really long nail, the apex is really important, because that is what is going to give the nail the strength, and that way it will last longer. So I'm almost done sculpting the nail. Now all I have to do is just cure it under the UV lamp for like 60 seconds. Some people, they keep the nails under the UV lamp for like 2 minutes. That depends on what kind of UV lamp you have, and accordingly you can place it under the UV lamp. Just ensure that your product is completely dried, and then all we have to do is just file and shape. So for the filing and shaping, I'm again using Model 1's filer. It is a 100-180 grit filer, and you can file, shape, and then you can apply a top coat, and your extension will be ready. So with the top coat application, our extensions are ready, and it looked really stunning. I must say Model 1 products are really really great. As you can see, the quality and application process, everything is really smooth and great. So in case if you're a beginner, or even if you're an expert nail technician, you can still buy their products and use it. And they have a huge variety of products available on their website, so I'll put all the links in the description box. This extension, I had so much fun creating these nails, but I know it's still not perfect. I need to figure out a few more things, but hey, there are no bubbles in this one this time. So my first extension, I had some marks after filing, but here I was able to manage it without any bubbles, so that is like one step more, like betterment. So that's it for today guys. I'll see you soon on my next video. Until then, stay safe, stay happy. Thank you.